This farm has been here for about 13 years, and we have so many enterprises. We started small, we kept on moving to come up with the best. I started with tea. That was 2003. We came up with our own name, me and my wife, Gladys. So my name is Bigabwa and she's Gladys. So it's where we came up with the name Big Lad. Then we added Agritourism Farm Limited. I have mangoes, 2 acres. I have bananas mixed with vanilla. Because once banana is not doing well, vanilla is doing well. Once the vanilla is not doing well, banana is doing very well. I go down to tea plantation. I have beekeeping. I started it of recent, but it is doing very well and it is bringing a lot of income. I got fish farming. I have those ones of tilapia and catfish. I have backyard fish farming here around. I go to macadamia. Macadamia, that one is the sweetest nut on the world market and very expensive on the world market. Most people eat it in KLM. Then we are having zero grazing projects, rabbitry, we are having poultry, piggery. Then we are adding value on whatever we are doing. We are producing, for example, BSF soils, compost manure from BSF, black soldier fly, greenhouse tomato production in a greenhouse. We are doing trainings at Big Lad. We bring different groups, different NGOs come just for training here. People from Gulu, from Amlata, from Jinja, from Iganga, from Mukono. Schools, all of them come here. Universities, they have been here for internship. For example, I got students from Berlin, Vienna, USA. We have skilled so many youth. Now they are doing what we have been doing here. And all of them, we are going to join hands. We come up with a circle. We start our own business. If they want to do it at their homes, they'll do it. And they have learned now projects that need a small piece of land. Even behind their father's, mother's places, they can start their what? Their own projects. In 2017, I was the second in the whole country. They took us to Netherlands. Where I was, I have added almost like 50% plus. I learned a lot in Netherlands because the system they were using were capital intensive. They were using machinery, machines milking cows, machines feeding animals. Everything was just machinery. And I looked at myself here. The farm was having so many different crops, of which is not in Netherlands. Netherlands, if you just say a mango grower, you remain a mango grower. And when I came back, a reciprocal of what actually I saw from Netherlands is what I started with. When I came back, the first thing was to organize my farm. I said, this one must be agritourism. Because in agritourism, you go to see small, but you go and do big. I looked at the farmers because they have been just producing crops and taking them just to these local markets. So they bring all their produce to Big Lad. Then we have to sort it, then we have to package it. Reaching the market, our produce actually is seen as a very good quality produce that we sell on the market. We are the directors. My mother is the accountant of this farm. We involve even our children so that we move with them so that we can have the farm for a long period of time. Whatever we sell, and we don't spend at source. We take our money to the bank. From the bank, then we start requesting. We make our own requisitions so that we can use the money from the bank. Beginning January, our factory, Big Lad Agroprocessing, will be starting. And we shall start with the constructions. Then our value addition will be on board. We know where I'm heading, and I'm heading for 300 years. Though I'll not be around, but my name will stay as Big Lad Agritourism Farm of this place.